Now, buying a car is one of life's big purchases, and you want to get it just right, which is why we turn to experts to spot any problems.
But what can you expect from a pre-purchase inspection, and what can you do if it misses a major issue? Alistair has the story.
We're in Wellington, where you can get to most places on foot, but Jack Matthews needed to go further afield.
I play football. That was honestly the main reason I needed a car.
Plus, his last ride.
So my last car was written off.
That makes me feel really safe about being in this car.
It wasn't my fault, no.
So a couple of months ago, he turned to Trade Me Motors and found this 2004 Subaru Legacy from a private seller for $4,200.
I just wanted a car that was issue-free and would sort of serve me well while I had it.
Before buying, Jack requested a pre-purchase inspection. The owner took it to the AA, the Automobile Association's Kapiti branch. The purpose of these inspections at AA are to communicate the overall condition of a used vehicle. This is based on external checks. They don't take the car apart in any way. So if they can't determine the cause of a fault, the customer will be told further investigation is needed.
I had full trust in the AA that they'd, you know, sort of do right by me.
And the result?
So the only issue on the report was a small battery fault and the surface rust as well. I thought, okay, you know, AA seems to think this is fine, so I'll go ahead with the purchase and, yeah, we should be okay.
But when he got home...
I clicked the key and I could hear some of the locks working, but it didn't quite sound like all of them were actually functioning.
That's because the central locking system wasn't working, and that's just hours after the inspection. The key fob only locked the driver's door and the boot. So how do you have to lock your car now?
Well, I'll take you through it. So I start with the back doors. Just have to do the locks there. And then I come around to the other side. This door has a special trick. So open that up, do the lock, and then you just have to time the handle like that.
Sorry. It's quite old school.
Yes, yeah, very old school. Doing it the old school way, totally.
Okay, Jack can lock the car manually, so not a major issue, but how could the system break in a day? A week later, Jack took his car into a second AA branch in Wellington Central for a full service. Further faults were picked up. It's important to note this is more thorough than a pre-purchase inspection. It found...
three actuators had actually failed. The rear wiper fluid not spraying. So there's obviously some surface rust under the car. The oil leak, the CV boot needed to be replaced. And also just a brake flush needed to be done as well.
The surface rust and sump oil leak didn't need to be fixed right away. The CV boot and brake flush service were relatively cheap to fix, but the locking system and rear wiper washer, not so much.
Yes, so the central locking system would be $1,513 to replace, and then the rear wiper fluid repair would be, yeah, around about $600.
And those actuators? Well, they're the devices that sit inside of a door that basically operate the locks. Three of those were found to be faulty in Jack's car, the two rear passenger doors and the front passenger door.
It was quite a shock when I got that bill, yeah.
A shock because he bought the car based on an inspection that gave him assurance this car was good to go.
Maybe, yeah, the AA must have missed something here. If I'd known about these issues, then I absolutely would have steered clear of the car.
Jack had questions. Did AA Kapiti miss the central locking in their inspection? Could three actuators really stop working in a matter of hours?
For them to all fail in a short period of time is highly unlikely.
Fairgo got a second opinion from Craig Draper at Fredco Motors.
Highly unlikely that all three actuators have failed within a matter of hours. Progressively, actuators on those model of car are troublesome, so it is not uncommon for the actuators to fail. I think it would be fair to say that the central locking system is probably quite easy to miss. The locking, opening and closing of all the doors would definitely be checked. A thorough inspector may go that extra bit and check the central locking.
To be fair, on the AA inspector checklist, there's no box check for the locking system. So should there be an expectation for it to be picked up?
It is very hard to pick up on everything on every single car, and every inspector may miss things. It's just human nature that not everything can be seen and there are mistakes made. Well, your first recourse is back to the inspecting organisation and say, look, I've bought this car, It's now being discovered that we've got some defects, and how can we resolve the issue?
Jack did go back to AA Kapiti, but...
They said, OK, we might have missed the rear wiper fluid, that might be on us, but they seem to keep claiming that the locks are working on the day of the inspection, which I just, yeah, I find that quite hard to believe.
Fair Go asked AA's head office whether it was satisfied its Kapiti branch inspectors checked all the locks of the car and how they were checked.
It also says that the AA Kapiti inspectors test the central locking system by activating the locks and then going in manually and checking that each door can lock and then unlock. But at first it said those manual checks did not happen.
We sincerely apologise to Jack for this error. NZAA franchisees strive to deliver a quality service to all customers, and where this hasn't happened, we'll always work with the customer to put things right. AA Kapiti are committed to doing this and understand they have offered to assist with the issues outlined and are hoping to hear back from Jack on this.
AA head office has since changed its response, saying it received further information that AA Kapiti's inspector reiterated they did in fact carry out the proper manual checks. One thing does remain consistent from them though, they're committed to helping Jack.
I mean, this is the dream outcome, right, for me. So they're offering to totally replace the central locking system. That's a $1,500 repair, which I was going to have to front up for previously, so that's stunning, really.
Yeah, good result.
Nice work.
Yeah.
So the external only inspection Jack had was around $200. You'll pay more for a more in-depth inspection, or our mechanic suggested just take the inspection notes to your own trusted mechanic to see if they spot any red flags.
The old second opinion. In general though, like all of us, the older the car, the more used we are, the more likely we are to have issues. So it's really important to get some form of pre-purchase inspection done.